I'm Charles Bankhead of MedPage Today. A study published in the New England Journal of Medicine showed similar outcomes after anterior cruciate ligament injury in patients who had immediate surgery and those who underwent rehabilitation and delayed surgery. Ultimately, more than half of the conservatively managed patients avoided surgery. I'm speaking by video phone with Dr. Bruce Levy of the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota, who wrote an editorial that accompanied the article. Thank you for joining us. Dr. Levy, is the decision to defer surgery after ACL injury really as straightforward as this study might suggest? Can a majority of people recover without surgery?
I think that's a great question. I think the most important thing to recognize when dealing with an ACL injury is that no two patients are the same and no two injured knees are the same. So it's very hard to advocate one single treatment strategy for all ACL injuries. For example, if you have a high-performance, high-demand collegiate soccer player who's involved in planting, pivoting, cutting-type maneuvers on uneven terrain, that's a patient who most likely would not be able to get by without an ACL reconstruction if they wanted to resume that level of activity. However, somebody who's, let's say, 35 and a recreational tennis player or maybe a cyclist or a jogger might do very well with non-operative treatment with brace and rehabilitation. So I think that there are patient-related factors that come into play, and there's also associated knee injury-related factors. For example, if a patient has a meniscal tear that the surgeon feels is repairable, and you fix that meniscus but you don't fix the ACL, there's a high risk of failure of that meniscal tear. And ultimately, at the end of the day, the long-term prognosis of an ACL deficient knee may not be related to whether or not somebody feels instability, but on the status of the meniscus and the articular cartilage, because those, when they're damaged, may lead to arthritis. So it's really not, in my opinion, as straightforward as trying to advocate one singular treatment strategy. I think that the decision to do an ACL reconstruction needs to be individually tailored to meet the specific needs of the patient.
You had an opportunity to review the article before writing your editorial. What is your overall impression about the study and the results?
I think actually the paper is very well done. It's not easy to do a study on surgery versus no surgery. Most research studies are treatment A versus treatment B, or a surgical technique of one sort compared to another. But to have patients actually randomized into a trial of surgery versus no surgery, or the option to have delayed surgery, is a very difficult task. And so I think the authors really should be commended, because taking on that type of a project is not straightforward. And I think overall the paper was very well done. And I think that it adds quite a bit to the current body of literature in ACL reconstruction, and in my mind really confirms that not all patients need ACL reconstruction.
What messages does this article have for surgeons, team physicians, trainers, and other healthcare professionals who might be involved in the care of people who have ACL injuries?
I think the implications of the paper is basically severalfold. One is that it does confirm that some patients can do well depending on their activity levels and depending on their associated injuries to the knee, in particular the meniscus and cartilage. Those patients can do well at times without surgery. So not every patient, in my opinion, needs an operation, certainly not maybe right away. So I think from that standpoint, the paper is very helpful. But I also think that the data needs to be interpreted with just a little bit of caution. And that's because, number one, it was a relatively small subset of patients. Number two, it was relatively short-term follow-up. So 2 years, although adequate to sort of know if somebody can return to their pre-injury activity level, is really very early to know the long-term outcome of treatment. And so really, if you look at the two treatment strategies, strategy one, which was early reconstruction, versus strategy two, which was rehabilitation with the option of delayed surgery, already 40% of the patients in the optional group have already had their ACLs reconstructed. 22% at 1 year, 40% at 2 years, most likely going to increase over time. And the people that had delayed surgery had a higher rate of meniscal procedures during the follow-up period, which also brings forth the point that if you leave the ACL alone and you have recurrent instability or giving way episodes, you're putting yourself at risk for further damage to the meniscus and articular cartilage. So I think that 2 years might be a little early to know the long-term benefits or consequences of each of the treatment strategies. And really the bottom line for me is that every patient warrants a discussion regarding operative and non-operative management, pros and cons, and that ultimately the decision to do an ACL reconstruction is really up to the patient, the physician, and the family if indicated, and everybody joining their thoughts together and seeing what they feel would be the best in the best interest of the patient.
Thank you for joining us today, Dr. Levy. For MedPage Today, I'm Charles Bankhead.